Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to walk through solving a problem using the false position method in Google Sheets. So, our problem states to find the rightmost root of the following function using the false position method to an error level of 0.05. Our function here is 4x squared plus 3x minus 3. Just a quick note, if you missed our previous video on the theory behind the false position method, I will leave a link in the description below for you to check out first. Just remember that the false position method is used for finding the roots of a nonlinear equation. So, to begin, let's just create some headers for our table. So, let's assume that A is going to be our lower boundary input value, and B is going to be our higher boundary input value. C is going to be somewhere in the middle of these two values, and it is based off our A and B values. F of A, F of B, and F of C will be found using the function's roots that we are solving for. Next, we need a column that determines which of the two inputs, f of a times f of c and f of b times f of c, gives a negative value. This will tell us in which direction we need to move, whether that be left or right. Then lastly, we need to calculate the error at any given iteration, which is the absolute of our c at our next iteration minus our c at our current iteration. Now, for this first iteration, we need to assign A and B values based on what we found in our positive or negative product test that we performed in the previous iteration. To accomplish this, we are going to use a simple if statement. So, to do so, we type equals if and then a logical statement. So, that means something that will either be true or false. So, we select the value given by f of A times f of C and test if that is less than zero. If true, that means our root is to the left of our midpoint, and A will remain unchanged, whereas B will take on the midpoint's value. If false, the root is to the right of the midpoint, and A will take on the midpoint C's value. We will repeat the same formula for our higher root boundary B. Now, we are free to bring down all of the rows. Just note that every time we create a new row like this, we're basically iterating another step, much like we did in the previous video, except this method, using Google Sheets, is much faster. As you can see, after a few iterations, our error term is lower than our acceptable value, which means that we are done. We could also depict our function and boundaries in the following way. Create small steps in the x direction, let's say 0.01, and we will go from our initial bounds of 0 to 1. Then, beside this, we can apply the inputs to our function and get the outputs. Next, we can graph the function and visually see that we do indeed have a root between these two points, 0 and 1. Next, let's just create a line in our graph to show where our current iteration of the false position method places us in relation to our root. And there you go. We have just completed a problem using the false position method in Google Sheets. One additional thing that is cool to add is a validation that we indeed do have a root between two boundaries. So, to accomplish this, let's create an if-or statement that states if f of a times f of c or f of b times f of c, and just note the syntax here, is less than zero, we print true. There is at least one root present. Or, if it is false, we print that. The only time this could give us trouble is if you have more than one root present within your boundaries, and you can ensure this doesn't happen by simply graphing the function like we just did. Just as a final note here, you can really use this Google Sheets that you just created to solve for any function you want. All you need to do is adjust the formula here for f of a, copy and paste that into f of b and f of c, and f of x for iteration 0, and 1 here. Copy and pasting works here well, as our input term is always directly to the left of our cell that we are solving for, which is the output for that given input. Then, lastly, you just adjust your boundaries A and B to contain a single root within them. This may take some adjusting, but can easily be done through plotting the function like we did here on the right. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we find the root of a nonlinear equation using the false position method in Google Sheets. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking the join button down below or our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.